Welcome. In this movie, we will demonstrate the PDS 2000 project wizard to set up a PDS project for Blueview Sonar from scratch. See other movies for defining the screen layout and the use views, or how to operate PDS by using the views. Click the PDS 2000 icon on the desktop to start PDS 2000. PDS 2000 starts. We see now an error message as there is not a PDS 2000 project loaded. Click OK. And now, by ticking this Run New Project Wizard checkbox and click OK, we can start the new project wizard to create our project. Start PDS 2000 and there is already a project loaded. The PDS Control Center will start. From the Control Center, we can start the new project wizard from the File menu. So I click File. And now I can start the new project wizard when I click New Project. And the wizard will start. Or alternatively, I can go to File and then to Open Project. And I can click the checkbox Run New Project Wizard and click OK. And the wizard will start from this point. So different ways to start the new project wizard. The first step of the wizard will be to give the new project a name. In this example, Blueview. So I enter Blueview, click Next to continue. In the displayed project configuration dialog, we can set all kinds of settings, like the units. For example, our speed units. Or our distance units. Also important is to set your pitch units correctly. In this example, bow up positive. The same for your roll units. In this example, port up positive. Do this for all units you like to set. Also very important is to set your coordinate system. When I clicked coordinate system, you can create a new one by click new. The new coordinate system wizard starts. But when you click select, you can select for each country a existing coordinate system. For example, the USA. And let's say California, zone 1. I click OK. And California Zone 1 is selected with its parameters. When you click Edit, you can only edit parameters of a new created coordinate system. When a coordinate system is selected, click Next to continue. Next step is to select the correct application type. For a Blueview Sonar application, we select Multibeam Survey. Click Next to continue. Now we can create a configuration for the project by means of a wizard. Tick the checkbox and click Next. Give the configuration a name. For example, spread. Click Next to continue. First, we have to add a vessel configuration to the configuration. Click Add. When available, you can select an existing vessel configuration. As this is a new project, nothing is available. Click therefore Add New. Give it a name. In this example, BV vessel, and click Next to continue. In the geometry page, we can define the shape of our vessel. We can select standard defined shapes, like a medium survey boat. The sizes of this shape can be changed. Or when we have a drawing available of our vessel, we can use this. For now, we use a standard shape. We also have to define our device offsets. Click Add. Give the offset a name and enter the correct offsets with respect to a chosen vessel reference point, called zero offset. For the GPS, for example, refer to the user manual for the correct convention. Do the same procedure for the other devices, like the sonar. The device offsets are listed. Click Overview for an overview, or click one of the device offsets to edit it. With the Edit button, click Next to continue. In this page, we have to add our used equipment for the project. Click Multibeam All Options and select Blue View. Click Add to add it to our equipment. In the Appeared dialog box, you can select the options you like to use for the Blue View sonar. For this sonar, Multibeam, Sonar Image, Sonar Configuration, Sonar Byte. Click OK to continue. For this project, we will also add a positioning system. We select from the Positioning Systems Geox group a NMEA device like GGA GST. Click Add and the positioning system is added. Same for our motion device, Vertical Reference Unit. In this example, a TSS. And finally, a compass. In this example, a NMEA. Like HDT we add. We have now added all our equipment in the list. When you double click on a device, you must set the properties of it. If we select the device offset box, we can select one of the earlier defined device offsets, in this case GPS. Now the device offset becomes the GPS device offset. Also the timestamp mode must be defined. So if I select timestamp mode, I can select from the drop-down box the correct one, in this case computer clock. Click OK when finished. Do the same for the other devices. So double click on compass. The compass properties are displayed. For a compass, the heading correction must be set for compensation of any misalignment in installation. So you need to calibrate your equipment for an accurate survey. Same for the motion sensor. Double click on it. Select the correct device offset. Set a heading correction. Set a correct roll and pitch correction for the motion sensor. Also the properties of the multibeam must be set. Select the correct device offset. Select the correct heading correction and the correct roll and pitch correction. In this example, minus 45. Also properties of the sonar image must be set. The same device offset is selected as under the multibeam device. Also, the pitch and roll offset must be set. For the sonar configuration and the sonar byte device, no properties needs to be set. Now we have to set up our I/O ports for the different equipment. Click on a device, in this case positioning system Geox, it gets blue, and click I/O port. The interfacing dialog box appears on the screen. In this case already a lot of ports are defined. When the positioning system is connected to COM1 of the computer, you can select COM1 and set the correct baud rate, data bits, parity, etc. Of course, this should match with the used baud rate of the connected equipment, in this case the GPS. In this case, I change to 9200 as this is the baud rate of my connected GPS receiver. In case the port is not listed in the interfacing dialog, so not defined, I have to add it, so I click the Add button. In this dialog, you can select which type of port you like to add, so for example a serial port. Click Serial and OK. Enter the numerical COM port number. Of course, this COM port number should also exist on your computer. So for example, we like to add COM port number 6. COM port 6 is now in the list. We do the same for the compass. We select compass, gets blue, and select I/O port. And we select in this case the serial COM port on which we have connected the compass. COM port 2 in this example. Same for the motion sensor. We also have to set the I/O port for the BlueView sonar. In this case, the BlueView port is not yet defined, so we click the Add button. Since the BlueView sonar is connected by an Ethernet connection to the computer, we have to define a network port name. Give it a name like BlueView and you have to enter the correct IP address of the sonar. .168.1.45 is a standard IP address for a BlueView sonar. Select the same I/O port for the sonar image. As you just created it, you have only to select it. Same for the sonar configuration device. And finally, the sonar byte device as well. If needed, you can test interfacing by select the device and select the device test button. So in this case, the positioning system, which is now displayed on my second connected screen. When the equipment has been set up correctly, you can click Next to continue the visit. The next page is the Computations page. There is no need to set this up. Click Next to continue. Data sources can be set. There is no need to do this for BlueView application. Click Next to continue. In the guidance page, routes, run lines, waypoints, etc. can be set. Click Next to continue. Different logging formats can be selected. For BlueView applications, we use the PDS 2000 format, which is always enabled and cannot be disabled. If required, logging conditions can be set. Click Next to continue. Simulation parameters can be set. Click Next to continue. In the next page, aliases can be set. We can change, for example, positioning system Geox in a different name. Like position. Click Next to continue. And finally, alarms can be defined. Click Finish to finish the configuration visit. Click OK. And now the vessel configuration is added. Layout will be defined online. Click Next to continue. Events can be defined. Click Next to continue. And finally, alarms can be defined. Click Finish to finish the visit. And finish again. So now we have created a project BlueView with the application type multi-beam survey and the configuration spread. As you can see in the PDS 2000 control center when selected.
Teledyne RESON, everywhere you look.